A warm good morning, everyone. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. With this verse, we will start this webinar session, preparing for government jobs, with a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth, and everything within, we thank you for this wonderful time. We thank you for all the blessings and bounties we have showered. We praise you for your grace that made us children of your own. We thank you for this wonderful college you have given us. We look towards you to bless this wonderful occasion. Bless every single person attending this webinar. Bless our resource person, Dr. Vipul Azmi, and bless our principal, faculty, and staff members, and give you our training and placement division. Bless the students, grant the students your wisdom, knowledge, so they come out in flying colors. Forgive our sins and lead towards us to hear our prayers, O Lord. Safeguard us from this COVID and keep us safe. Help us to hold on to you every minute, every second. All praise, glory, and honor be unto the Almighty Creator, loving Savior, and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Welcome the challenges. Look for the opportunities in every situation to lead and grow in wisdom. Now I request Mrs. Nancy, Assistant Placement Officer, Training and Placement, to deliver the welcome address, followed by the resource person introduction. Over to you now.
Give thanks to the Lord Almighty for life's greatness. It's a beautiful day, though it's very sunny. It's a unique day, though it's very one among our calendar. Small cheer and great welcome makes our merry feast. First of all, I would like to thank everyone for giving this opportunity. I would like to welcome our principal, Dr. Paul Varaharan, who has been a pillar of support of all the activities in training and placement division. I would like to welcome our dean, Dr. Dhanbar sir, and associate dean, our resource person, Dr. Victor Lasser sir, and Dr. Isaiah sir, and Dr. Shiva Princess ma'am. I would like to welcome all the heads of the departments, faculties of our college. And also, I welcome Training and Placement Officer and Team Training and Placement Division. Last but not least, a warm welcome to the students who are interested in taking up government jobs for future decisions. Now, I would like to introduce our associate dean and our resource person, Dr. Victor Lasser, sir. Creative people are complex and multi-talented, along with the benefit of many abilities and passion. The words from the reputed persons always inspire us to set a goal and move on to make the dream come true. I have seen a great teacher in you, sir. Dr. Victor Lasser, sir, Associate Dean of Training and Placement Division, joined the Department of Management Studies as Associate Professor in the year 2014 and offers an untired services to this premier institution since then. He was a meticulous teacher and an amiable personality. His work experience is not only in the field of education, but also in the field of national level work in environmental like Southern Railways. He has joined as a commercial controller in the Divisional Railway Manager, Southern Railway, to Trapally in the year 1991, since 1997. And then he has worked as the senior instructor in the Zonal Railway Training Institute, Southern Railway, to Trapally in the year 1997 to 2005. And also he has worked as the chief instructor in the Zonal Railway Training Institute, Southern Railway, Trichinopoly in the year 2005 to 2014. He has also served as the assistant professor in the Department of English, TPML College, Porayur, Tamil Nadu in the year 1992-1991. He was a staff advisor of Heber Consultancy Services. He has the credits of trained 2 batches of officers and engineers of Southern Railways and 1 batch of second line leaders of Bishop Heber College. He was awarded a bronze medal in the national level of diploma in railway transport economics management. He has published 19 national and 13 international research papers. He has credit of authored and published a life skills course book for undergraduate of all disciplines. He has won All India Best NCC Cadet Award in the year 1985. He has also awarded Tamil Nadu Government Merit Scholarship for Outstanding NCC Cadet in the year 1986. He was a member of Board of Studies in 10 colleges and also a Vice Chancellor nominee in 3 colleges. He was a national trainer in 21 different government and other public sector. He was a visiting professor for more than 75 colleges in Tamil Nadu. He has a credit of trained more than 75,000 employees as a frontline staff trainer and also a MVP, FTP and TOT trainer for polytechnics, engineering, arts and science colleges, schools and B schools. He was a referee for an international journal of project organizations and management. He was a research guide for MBA students of IGNO in New Delhi and Pondicherry University and also a research guide for MBA, MPhil and PhD scholar in Bharathidas University. He was academic counselor of IGNO and for Pondicherry University. He was a patron of Miss Career Africa, an international body for empowering African women of poverty and to create their own business. He was a mentor of student-centered activities like campus company, Friday market leadership and entrepreneurship schemes, consultancy, government exam and government schemes and Bishop Paper College in 2014. A person with numerous experience is worth thousands of books in a library. One such valuable book is you and your experience in all various fields that you have succeeded through. You are truly a great inspiration to all of us, sir. So we are blessed to have you with you, sir. Now I hand over to moderator, Mr. Moses.
Thank you, ma'am, for the wonderful introduction about our resource persons. Students, I have one information to share you. Kindly mute yourself during the session, and if you have any questions or doubts, kindly drop it in the chat box. We have a separate Q&A session. During that time, our resource person will clarify all your doubts and your queries. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. This is Nancy Lydia, the Assistant Placement Officer of Indian Area of Training and Placement, for the beautiful introduction about me. Thank you, Mr. Moses, Training and Placement Officer, who helps me today in moderating this beautiful workshop on facing the government examinations. On the outset, let me thank the Indian Area of Training and Placement for giving me this very beautiful opportunity of meeting the younger minds, particularly the final year students of undergrads and postgrads of Bishop Paper College. I'm also happy that the first year and second year students are connected through YouTube. And I'm also really happy that a lot of alumnus of Bishop Paper College have also joined in the YouTube to listen and to understand where exactly the government examinations can lead us and could make a good career for us. Before I could start my lecture on facing the interview for the next 70 minutes, let me thank the Dean of Training and Placement, Dr. Dhanapal, for giving me an opportunity to face all of you. I should also thank Dr. Isaiah and Dr. Shiva Princess, the Associate Deans, who take care of various activities of this degree of Training and Placement in helping almost the final year students of undergrads and postgrads of Bishop Paper College in their placements and their career development. And in training the first years and second year students and first year PG students of Bishop Paper College in building their career so that when they come to the final years, so they will go out and fly in colors. I also would like to place on records all the work done by the Assistant Placement Officers and the entire team of training and placement for having met almost all the student friends through Google Form and getting you all get connected. The mighty students of Bishop Paper College and all the alumnus and other friends who are connected directly as well as through YouTube. Majority of the student community are actually not happy or otherwise not prepared getting into the government examinations for a very simple reason is that we always say that lakhs of people apply, but the number of vacancies are only handful. Lakhs and lakhs of people are applying, but the number of vacancies are only handful. Take for example, the civil service examination for IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS, and so on. At least 10 lakh people apply every year. But I don't know how many of you will really understand that out of the 10 lakh people who apply for the examination, the very serious contenders are only 50,000 people. Because out of 10 lakh people who apply, at least 2 lakh people, they don't even appear for the examination. So if you could really go and do an analysis, 50,000 students are very serious about the examination. Like that, even banking sector, Harvard, TNPSC, like that. Today we are going to see almost all the government sectors possibly in another 70 minutes, after which you can post your questions as instructed by our Assistant Principal Officer, Mr. Moses. I have also brought some slides for you people. I would request all of you to take your notebook and a pen and copy it out or take a photoshoot of whatever that has been displayed in the screen, so that you will be really astonished to find out there are so many departments in the government sector which has not been actually introduced to all of us. The people who know that there are so many governmental posts available, they quietly prepare and get into such categories of postings. May I request Moses sir to display the screen for me so that you'll be able to understand the various areas that we are supposed to explore. Facing government examinations, actually there are 4 places where a student who has got an undergraduate degree or a postgraduate degree who can definitely get into. Number one is the private sectors, where nearly 80% of these students after their graduation and post-graduation are placed. The private sector. Then there is a sector called public sector. Hardly 3% of the students can get placed. There is another sector called the quasi-sector, semi-governmental, where hardly 1% of students can get placed. But the next major area where somebody can think about getting into a fine-tuned job is there only in the government sector. And the government sectors, we have got UPSC, TNPSC, SSC means Staff Selection Commission, banking sectors, insurance sectors, Indian Railways, uniformed services like Indian Army, Indian Navy, Air Force, along with the police department, that Indian Army, Indian Navy, and Indian Air Force has been grouped into defense, and all other public sectors. So what I'm trying to tell you is that this morning we will concentrate on the public sectors as well as the government sectors and the major hobbies for the government sector. Nearly 16-17% of the job available in the market today is there in the government sector. But the problem that we have to face is that every selection is done through an examination. Earlier, it used to be just only one examination. But now they are conducting preliminary examinations and main examinations. And soon after the main examinations are conducted, you are invited to come for an interview. But in railways, even that interview has been taken off. So if you clear an examination and if you come in the rank list, automatically you are sent for the training and then you are placed in Indian Railways. So friends, this slide that has been projected, nearly 8 areas we are going to discuss. And I know it is so very voluminous, time may not be enough, but I would like to give you or throw some light on these areas so that you'll be able to decipher, understand, and then I'll also tell you where and all you can browse, after my session is over, so that building your career in government examinations become your long-time career in your life. Before we move on to the next slide, I would like to remind you about the various factors Number one is, every government examination, they say that you should be a graduate. Basically, you should be a graduate. And they call it as any graduation. Any graduation means BA or BSc or BCom or BBA or even MBBS or BDS or BE or BVOC. Or it could be even any postgraduate, MA, MS, MBA, so on and so forth. So once you become a graduate, I hope people who are listening to me have either become graduates or to be graduates. So we are definitely eligible to apply for a government examinations once we are a graduate. And the government says you can be any graduate. Number two, they're talking about the age factor. The minimum age for entering is 18. In some cases, it is 21. Maximum goes up to 30, 35, with relaxation for SCST, OBC community. So as far as the age is concerned, we are very much within the margin. So qualification is there. Age factor, we are very much in. The third factor is, majority of the students studying in college curriculum, they are not aware that there is a percentage, certain percentage of reservation for the community to which I and you belong. SC community students are given 15% of a reservation in the central government examinations, 18% of reservation in the state government examinations. Scheduled tribe ST category, they are given a concession of 7.5% in the central government. There is a category called OBC, other backward classes. In Tamil Nadu state, the reservation is given for BC and MBC. Now they are given nearly 10.5% for a particular community called the Vanniyars. So in Tamil Nadu state government, there is a separate reservation for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, backward classes, most backward classes. They have got even 3.5% of reservation for the Muslim community coming in Tamil Nadu. And now the government has also introduced the central government category called EWS, economically weaker sections, a 10% of reservation. So nearly 70% of the posts are given for reserved people in Tamil Nadu. In the central government, nearly 50% of are now the EWS getting 10%. Almost half of the population are getting their postings only through such categories of reservation. So my earnest advice for all of you is that please understand to which community you belong to and get the community certificate very much ready before you apply for any of these government sectors. I would like to reiterate this point again. SC certificate, scheduled caste certificate issued by Government of Tamil Nadu for Tamil students, Tamil people, is enough for applying for central government examinations. ST certificates issued by Government of Tamil Nadu is enough for applying for central government examinations. Whereas BC, MBC certificates issued by Government of Tamil Nadu is not enough for taking the 27% of reservation in OBC in central government examinations. If you can see the screen, except TNPSC, almost all the examinations are semi-government examinations. Only in TNPSC, we have got 8 groups. Maybe we know only group 1, group 2, but there are 8 groups. Apart from the TNPSC, UPSC, SSC, Bank, Insurance, Indian Railways, Uniformed Services, Defense, all public, everything is central government examinations. But all the central government offices are available very much in Tamil Nadu, in all other states of the country. So if you are a BC or an MBC in Tamil Nadu, please obtain an OBC certificate. And when you go and take an OBC certificate, the Tahsildar will ask you, are you a creamy category of OBC or a non-creamy category of OBC? Which means, if your parents' income per annum is less than 8 lakhs, then you are called OBC non-creamy. BC and BC in Tamil Nadu state, to get an OBC certificate for 27% of reservation, you have to buy an OBC non-creamy certificate. If you get a creamy certificate, that is not valid for getting 27% reservation. So if you don't come under any of these categories, you are called a general category. And that general category is what is called others. So when you fill your application, it is better that you need to have a graduation and you should be within the age limit. And if you seek any reservation, you need to have a community certificate, appropriate community certificate, so that now you'll be able to get all this percentages in this. So I'll go one after the other and tell you and stop for even reiterating this area so that you'll be able to understand it better. The first one is about the every student, you know, they are interested in becoming an IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS. These are the All India Civil Services post available. Indian Administrative Service, Indian Police Service, Indian Forest Service. It's called IAS, IPS, IFOS. Then we have got a Group A Civil Services called Indian Foreign Service, IFS. Like that, you know, IAAS, ICAS. We have got, you know, so much of services. Nearly 24 services are available in UPSC post itself. Some of us, most of us are introduced only to IAS or IPS or sometimes to IRS. But friends, there are nearly 24 categories in UPSC post itself. But to get these postings, you have to apply for an examination called the Civil Service Examination, CSE. Every year, at least 1,000 postings are called. And from almost all the graduates available in the whole of the country, nearly 10 lakh people apply for the preliminary examination. And hardly 10,000 people clear the prelims to go to the main examination. And in the main examination, nearly 3,000 students get into the interview session. And out of the 3,000 students, the top 100 are given Indian Administrative Service called IAS. It may look very tough, but for a person who consistently prepares, who consistently understands the syllabus and starts his own preparation by getting other materials to his own hand, I think it becomes easy for anybody to crack and become the Indian Administrative Service postings. And if you are not coming in the rank of the top 100 or top 200, there are other postings like IRTS, you get ICFS, you get IRS, you get ITS, you get into Railway Protection Force as an officer, you get into Armed Forces Headquarters Civil Service, you also get into the Pondicherry Civil Service, you also get into Delhi, Andaman Nicobar, Lakshadweep, Daman, Dayu, even to the Union Territories, you are posted. So this is a very very beautiful postings wherein you are given a vehicle to move, you are given a person to be an assistant for you, you are given a very beautiful office, and by and large, you'll be able to one signature from your pen will change the lifestyles, it will change the complete future of the Indian population. So friends, UPSC is a very beautiful concept. And the basic requirement for applying for UPSC is a graduation. Finally, as students of undergrads who are listening to me, all the postgraduate students who are listening to me who has already got a graduation in your pocket, please think about applying for this UPSC. Get into the internet and browse for the preliminary and the main syllabus. And you can go ahead in your preparation. And for further inquiry, further help, you are most welcome to contact us to the Deanery of Training and Placement. We'll be much obliged to help. And in this UPS post, I'd like to tell you that if you have all the prerequisites that I have told you about, the community service, if there are 100 IAS officers selected every year, through this UPSC civil service examination. At least 15 officers are from scheduled caste cadet. Nearly 8 people are from a scheduled tribe cadet. If you add this 15 and 8, it is 23. Whereas 27% is from other backward classes. This is where majority of the Tamil Nadu students are not aware that they can become an IAS through OBC category. They don't properly get the certificate. They apply with the BC or MBC certificate, which the central government does not agree to. So once your OBC non-creamy certificate is not applied, you go for the general category. So SCA certificate, if you have, you can get into the 15% category, not only in IAS, in IPS, in IRS, in IRTS, in IRAS, in all other categories, all other 24 categories. So OBC can get you 27 postings in IPS. If there are 100 vacancies, if there are 200, 27 plus 27, 54 people come from that. And there is a vacancy for the physically challenged people. You must have come across a lady who is visually challenged and become an IAS and become a district collector. So we have got ample opportunities for people who are from the challenged category too. And there are 10 vacancies or 10% for the economically weaker section. So I want you to understand where exactly you belong. If you don't come out any of this reserved categories, well, the balance is for the general category. TNPSC examination, normally I'll tell you about group 1, but there are 8 groups available. Maybe I can tell you, if anybody prepares for the civil service examinations for UPSC, IAS, IPS and so on, it will be easy for you to crack TNPSC group 1, even group 2. Group 2 or group 1, you know, group 1 we have got postings like a deputy collector, DSP, that postings are there, next slide. You got deputy collector, deputy superintendent of police, assistant commissioner of commercial taxes, deputy registrar of cooperative societies, like that. See, if you take the deputy superintendent of police, this posting comes directly for a graduate who clears group 1 examination. Otherwise, I'll tell you the hierarchy in police. The last category in the police department is Constable Grade 2. Constable Grade 2, Constable Grade 1, Head Constable, Sub-Inspector, Inspector, DSP, 6th rank, highest rank, ADSP, SP, EIG, IG, ADGP, DGP. And DGP or Director General of Police is the highest of power. Today, you must have seen Mr. Shailendra Babu or Dr. Shailendra Babu becoming the DGP of Tamil Nadu State. He was a graduate from Kanyakumari and joined IPS at the age of 25 after his graduation. And today, he holds the post of Director General of Police. He is a direct recruit from IPS, has become Assistant Commissioner, or this post called a DSP. You can also adorn this uniform. You can also become the Director General of Police of Tamil Nadu. And sometimes somewhere such a classes, a teacher like me will be telling your name. And you'll adorn the highest post of the police department in Tamil Nadu state as well. So I'm trying to tell you the reality. See, a DSP, a Deputy Superintendent of Police, he's going to sit directly on the heads of Constable Grade 2, Grade 1, Head Constable, Sub-Inspector, Inspector. And then, you know, DSP is going to control this entire team of people. So once you become a Deputy Superintendent of Police, you are given 6 police stations under your control. 6 police stations means 6 inspectors, 36 sub-inspectors, 150 constables and head constables. Can you just imagine you going on a police jeep, adorning the beautiful uniform, and then nearly 200 people wearing uniform saluting to you? And this police, Deputy Superintendent of Police, the other people come through promotion for the next 25 years. Within a short span of at the age of 21, 22 years with your graduation, clearing this JNPSC group and services, you can become an aspirant commissioner or otherwise you're called a deputy superintendent. Friends, it looks really very interesting to listen to become an IAS, IPS and all that. But if you ask an IAS officer and IPS officer, how did you become an IAS or IPS? I think there is a big story behind their success. They would have also listened to a session like this. They would have gone to the internet to browse the syllabus. And they would have really toiled nearly 15 to 16 to 20 hours a day. They would have gone to the library regularly. They have been regularly, reading newspapers and watching television for getting updated on every day's news. And with a lot of hard work, but who are at least 3 years, today they are what they are. So this session should really be an eye-opener for you guys. That all these postings are so beautiful. You become a district officer of fire and rescue services. You become in charge for 15 fire stations. And the whole district is under your disposal. If there is any fire anywhere, if there is any rescue to be done, and you are there as a disaster management officer, and the entire district runs behind you, they listen for your command. But see here, the minimum qualifying mark out of 850 is just 255 for SC, ST, OBC, MBC, these events denotified communities. I hope you understand the difference between other communities and the reserved communities. The qualifying mark itself is lesser, provided you have your community certificate. I trust on this for a very simple reason is that our students are not properly getting this community certificate, and that is why most of the government postings are taken by people from other states in the quota earmarked for Tamil Nadu students. If you go to Canara Bank today, or State Bank of India, you find people from Bihar, Rajasthan sitting in the counter, rather than a Tamil guy sitting there and then, taking care of our own banking sector in Trichy or Tanjavur or Thimbakuttum. We don't take any of these reservations. They write the examination and get this quota. You take a majority of the IAS offices and IPS offices in Tamil Nadu, you take the list and see. Majority of the names are North Indian names. Because we have not taken an OBC certificate, we have not applied our mind properly to get an OBC non-creamy certificate. We didn't understand that we get a non-creamy certificate only when our parental income are less than 8 lakh rupees. We have not bothered to go and disturb a tahsildar or a deputy inspector or a village administrative officer 2 or 3 times to get the certificate so that we can apply and take this 27% of what category. But we blame that to the other state students have come and occupied our positions. The vacancies available in government sectors, it comes in the newspapers. It comes in employment news. It is also, given to us through WhatsApp. And our deanery, our placement officer, our training and placement officer, our rescue placement officers, the entire deanery under the control of Dr. Dhanapal, we regularly send you that these are the government examinations called for. So we get that. But these things, these intricacies, these basic things, you have to do it. See, just 255 out of 850 to just get into a deputy collector or a DSP. Whereas for general category, for others, it becomes a cumbersome ticket 340. And if you go the next to the banking sector, so far I have told you about UPSC, civil service examination, TNPSC, and there are 8 groups in TNPSC. I have touched only one called group and services. But friends, you can browse to the internet to find out what are the other 7 groups in TNPSC. Tamil Nadu Public Service Commission. So you need to have a diary. You need to open the pages and then get to know everything about the UPSC if you are willing to become a civil servant. Or if you want to write only TNPSC, best find out what are the age categories available in TNPSC, what are the names of the postings, and then you know you will be able to prepare yourselves. Now we go to the major area called the banking sector. And before we understand about the clerical cadre or professional officers or specialist officers, I'd like to tell you that banks are of two types. One is the government sector or the banks that come under the government control. The second one is private banks. So government banks like the State Bank of India or Indian Overseas Bank or Canara Bank or Punjab National Bank, they are called nationalized banks. So you should browse to the internet to find out what are all the nationalized banks available. And for all the nationalized banks, there is a team which conducts examination called IBPS, Institute of Banking Personnel Selection. They control the complete nationalized banks, and for all the vacancies for clerical cadre or probationary officers or specialist officers, they conduct examinations regularly. Apart from these nationalized banks, all other banks, they call private banks like ICICI, HDFC, and so on. My advice for you guys, since you are here attached to becoming, facing the government examinations, to prepare for getting into the banks which are nationalized. You can try for clerical cadre or even officer cadre. But my advice will be for all of you is to initially prepare for clerical cadre. People who are in the undergraduate study, if any of the first year students from UG are listening to me, first year BSc or a BA, start preparing for the clerical cadre from today onwards, this moment onwards. Because the next 3 years, once the lockdown is over, next 2 years, at least 12 lakh vacancies are available in nationalized banks all over the country. So if your preparation starts from today, and by the time the call notice comes for you guys, you'll be readily available for taking this post. And once you become a clerk in a bank, you are given a promotion from within among the clerks. 1/3 of vacancies for officers are recruited from the clerical category available in the banking sector itself. So becoming an officer after becoming a clerk is also easy. Or you can become a clerk in the bank, start earning your salary, and then simultaneously prepare for the probationary officers also. The third one called specialist officer is something to do with the cyber crime today. If you just go to the internet and then type in the YouTube, online frauds in bank or ATM frauds in bank, simply type, you'll get at least some 200 videos. And in almost in all the videos, there is some fraudster who rings to somebody, calls somebody through mobile and say, and he tries to speak in Tamil. This fellow is not from Tamil Nadu. And he speaks in Tamil and say, sir, the card mele irukka andha 16 digit number, 44 number irukku, adha solunga sir. We really understand that a fellow, he is a fraud. But he is well trained. They have a call center. They are well trained. This fellow, basically his mother tongue is not Tamil, but he has learned Tamil to cheat us, to nab those idiots and culprits. Friends, we need specialist officers in all the banking sectors. So all the computer science students who are listening to me, computer engineers who are postgrads in Bishop Vipa College after your undergraduate in engineering, why don't you design a software to massacre and kill these idiots? The specialist officers are very much available, particularly people who learn bachelor of vocational course in information technology, BSc computer science, BCA, MSc computer science, MCA, BE in computer science, BE in electronics and computer engineering, BE in IT. We all learn, but we do not know that there is a category called that. Specialist officers, you'll be flying all over the country. And you'll be the most wanted officer in the banking sector. I want you to understand that the specialist officers are death. We do not have enough postings on enough people available in the market today to become specialists. So look at your graduation as a graduation that God has blessed you to learn computer science. Apply your mind and get into such postings. But always there is a question, where will I get know that they are calling for specialist officers? Every Saturday, a newspaper is published in New Delhi. Those days it was available only in Delhi, 20 years ago. Today, no sooner that newspaper is published in Delhi on Saturday, midnight on Saturday, it is available on the internet. Or Sunday or Monday, it is available in all the shops in all the cities in Tamil Nadu or all over the country. And it is called Employment News. This newspaper should be your lifeline. You have to buy the Employment News. And then if you can... So friends, I'm sorry for the interruption. Specialist officers are paid more than probationary officers. Specialist officers' rank of promotion is faster than probationary officers. Not only frauds are done by fraudsters from other states, there are culprits in the bank itself who let out the secrecy of the bank. So you can be a specialist officer or a vigilance officer taking care of your own banking sectors, containing such frauds within the bank where you belong to. So this Employment News that is published every Saturday in Delhi, it is very much available online. So every Sunday, I request all of you to browse the internet to read this Employment News. Around 36 pages, sometimes 24 pages, sometimes 48 pages. So now there are 24 pages on the magazine. Sometimes 48, sometimes 36. The first page, they give you a very beautiful article. Last page, some beautiful article. The balance tell you where and all jobs are available in the government sector and public sector. What are the latest call notice given by various banking sectors?
Yes.
ఏనా పరిగణ అనుకుంటారు మెసేజ్ సార్ இதில் பேச முடியா கேட்குமா ஐடியில் சாரி தேர் இஸ் அ பவர் ஃபெயிலியர் இன் அவர் பிளேஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஹோல்ட் ஆன் ஃபார் அ மினிட் Friends, we resume the meeting again. There was a power failure. Sorry for the interruption. We're talking about the specialist offices in the banking sector. This employment news that is published every Saturday in New Delhi, that will carry all the messages for you people. So you can join as good friends. At least one of you can find out what are all the job vacancies available. Every Sunday, if you browse the employment newspaper, it'll be able to tell you the exact post available for your qualification that you have taken from the certification. Apart from this banking sector, there is a major area which has not been explored, particularly in Tamil Nadu by our own people, is Staff Selection Commission. Staff Selection Commission. This Staff Selection Commission, almost selects thousands of students, thousands of graduates every year to various ministries and departments. I have given a few of the ministries available where you can very easily get into. This Audit and Accounts Department under the CNAG, all the commerce students and BBA students can decide and travel here. Central Secretariat Service, if you are a graduate with the knowledge in the typing, or you have studied a basic knowledge in computers, you get into the DOPT, Department of Personnel Training in Central Secretariat Service, Intelligence Bureau, Ministry of Railways, Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Defense. Next. You can become inspectors in various departments of the central government. Inspector of Income Tax, Inspector of Central Excise, Inspector as a Preventive Officer Inspector, Inspector exactly for examiner purposes, enforcement officers, and in narcotics. These postings like inspectors of income tax, customs, central excise, all these postings are selected only through Staff Selection Commission. This Staff Selection Commission, the notification comes only in the employment news. And every year they call at least 10,000 to 15,000 vacancies all over the country as inspectors. But the majority of the students getting selected from our state is very, very minimal. The reason being, number one, we are not aware that there are postings available through Staff Selection Commission. Number two, the majority of the coaching institutes that you have got, they are actually concentrating only on civil services or TNPSC or bank coachings. None of these people are taking this area because the coaching centers elsewhere away from Tamil Nadu are much stronger than the coaching centers in Tamil Nadu. So my earnest advice for all of you is, first of all, you understand what are the posts that come under the Staff Selection Commission. Need not go to any of these coaching centers, strong or weak coaching centers. You can convert your own house as your individual coaching centers. 3-4 friends can join together and do a group study. Almost all the nights are available for you. Evening 8 o'clock till next day morning 6 o'clock. At least 3 days in a week, if you can sit late night, 1 year midnight oil. I think these postings are very simple. You can just garner these postings. And I tell you, friends, a person who writes UPSC civil service examination, becoming an IRS, Indian Revenue Service officer, he becomes Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, direct recruit from UPSC. Please understand this concept very well. A direct recruit through UPSC civil service examination, getting an IRS, Indian Revenue Service category, he is directly posted as an Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. Whereas a person writing Staff Selection Commission become Inspector of Income Tax, a grade lower than Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. So if you cannot get the UPSC, nothing wrong. You can write SSC, become Inspector of Income Tax. Within 5 years, you become Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. And within 15 years of your service, you become Commissioner of Income Tax. And well, when you become 50 years of age, you become Chief Commissioner of Income Tax. Similarly for the other places also, the other categories also. But many students who aspire to become a civil servant through Union Public Service Commission, when they are not selected through that area, they just give up. Need not. The number of vacancies in IRS as Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax or Assistant Commissioner of Customs, Assistant Commissioner of Central Excise, maybe less than 200. Whereas Inspector of Income Tax, you get around 7,000, 8,000 vacancies across the country. So the preparations that you make, either for UPSC or SSC, does not go waste at all. Either you directly become an Assistant Commissioner, or you become an Inspector and become an Assistant Commissioner within 5 years. Sometimes, you know, students who prepare for UPSC to become IAS, if they don't get, they become fed up, they don't give for any examinations. But, you know, you can directly write TNPSC Group 1 and become a Deputy Collector. And within 15 years of your service, you become a conferred IAS in the state category itself. The majority of the collectors that you have in Tamil Nadu today, they would not have even come through UPSC directly, but they would have become a group officer in Tamil Nadu services, TNP, Tamil Nadu Public Service Commission. And then later, they would have become, with the 10, 15 years of regular service, the IAS post was conferred on them. So these nuances and intricacies about the government sectors, today it has been revealed to you guys. Only thing is, you'll have to go and learn a little more about this and then become any one of these officers in your category of your life. We also have categories like customs, central excise. Now this GST has come, service tax, appellate tribunals have come, Director General of Defense, Ministry of Defense, Central Bureau of Narcotics, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Ministry of Water Resources, Ministry of Textiles, Central Board of Direct Taxes, Indirect Taxes and Customs. All these names sometimes are new to us. Make them familiar. In all these places, you can become an inspector, or you can become an assistant commissioner, or you can become an undersecretary, you can become a deputy secretary, you can become a director, you can become a commissioner, you can become a chief commissioner. Any graduate, Vishwavidyalaya College has given you that. Age between 21 to 30, you are already there. Now we need to buy a community certificate. You understand the percentage reservation given for community certificates through this workshop. And everything is available. We all have a house, we have a TV at home, we have a mobile phone, we have a laptop connected to internet. One thing is, you have to be fast in your fingers to browse to find out whether all these things are really available. Which ministry shall I choose? What can I become in that? There are so many other postings available. You can become a hammal. You can become an attendant. You can become a peon. You can become a jamedar peon. You can become a record clerk. You can become a clerk, senior clerk, head clerk. You can become an office superintendent. You can become a chief office superintendent. That are all categories separately available for 10th standard and plus 2 qualifications. I'm talking about graduates who can adorn your best places as officers, as commissioners and deputy commissioners and chief commissioners, so that your grading, your signature can change lives, bring a reverberating change in your own personal life, your family, your natives, your siblings, and by and large, in the society. God has given you a graduation, the post-graduation. Please do not lose that. Directorate of Enforcement is the Department of Revenue, where we look for upright gentlemen, people who are not corrupt, people who do not adopt shortcut methodologies, people who really have faith in the government, faith in the nation. As Dr. Ambedkar has rightly put on the, you know, the pillars of the Indian Constitution, he says, India, by nature, is a sovereign, socialistic, secular, democratic republic. When we talk about people who are upright people, Vishwavidyalaya College has really made great people and upright people to penetrate into the societies as missionaries and a great zeal of interest in making this country a tariff-free nation. One such organization is called CBI, Central Bureau of Investigation. We want people who are really, really upright, God-fearing people to get into CBI, so that the people who are wrongdoers are taken to task and people who are really good are elected and elevated. Department of Post, National Investigation Agency, this NIA, not even a single person from our state is. Now we have understood that National Investigation Agency is a part of CBI. Minister of Statistics, people who do BSc Mathematics, BSc Statistics, BSc Physics and Chemistry with allied mathematics. Please try in Ministry of Statistics. Your statistics, you know, takes forward to understand about the GDP of the nation, takes forward to understand where exactly the country stands forthwith. Controller General of Accounts already discussed for BCom CA, BBA students, people have studied accountancy, business mathematics, to get into such offices and take care of the personal management of the employees. Indian Coast Guard is one area which is unexplored by many students from Tamil Nadu, in particular from Mission. Assistant Commandant, Deputy Commandant, Commandant of Indian Coast Guard, they require only one thing, a graduate from science discipline with physics or mathematics, either as main subject or allied subject. When you complete your plus two in science, biomass, enna degree pa padikalana, physics irukkudu, chemistry irukkudu, maths irukkudu, and sometimes, you know, we take kedaikiradhu or your parents push you. You do not know that you can command the whole ship and you can travel all over the world. You can go around the globe by becoming a commandant in Indian Coast Guard. Directorate of Enforcement discussed already. Ministry of Environment, Forest, Climate Change. That's a recent ministry where more of students from environmental studies are required, botany, zoology. You people can very easily write this examination, get into greater positions there. You can become scientist A, scientist B, the highest position that you can occupy in this Ministry of Environment and Forest and Climate, and the Narcotics Control Bureau. It's an allied agency of the police department. You also got Interpol, International Police Organization, and the recent Corporate Affairs Ministry has come. People, the Ministry of Corporate Affairs controls all the corporates that are connected through information technology and ITES, information technology enabled services. Ministry of Mines takes care of particularly the coal industry. Coal is one, you know, which controls the lifeline of the nation. Ministry of Communication, Department of Post. There are enough departments available, enough postings available. Only thing is, we have not got enough people to apply and seriously learn, study, and get the postings. We have heard about High Court and Supreme Courts, Divisional Courts, or District Courts, or PD, PDJs, and there is a court called this. CAT called Central Administrative Tribunal, where a grieved employee can go and approach the CAT, Central Administrative Tribunal, and vent his grievances and get redressed. You can occupy greater positions in CAT. With your knowledge, your prowess, you'll be able to bring justice to the people for just. Election Commission of India. Recently, we have seen the election in Tamil Nadu, and we have talked about election commissioner. Friends who are listening to me, imagine about getting into the postings called election commissioners. You will be an election commissioner for the state, election commissioner of the entire country, and you will be the person who will select the prime minister and the chief minister of the state and the country. Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, National Informatics Center, Computer Science Students, National Technical Research Organization, occupying the President's Secretariat and Vice President's Secretariat, a dream come true for our people. All these, you know, require you to appear for an examination. Clear an examination. Go for a face-to-face interview. Prove yourself in the interview. And then, you know, adorn this position so that you bring glory for your own personal life and for your family. These are the various postings available. Assistant Audit Officer, sometimes, you know, non-gazetted and gazetted. Junior statistical officer, auditor, accountant, section officer, assistant commissioner, deputy commissioner, commissioner, various names. We also know about section officer, undersecretary, deputy secretary, director. I just want to give you the names so that, you know, this comes to your knowledge, it comes to your understanding. If you become a section officer in a particular ministry, Ministry of Textiles or Ministry of Communication or Ministry of Urban Development, somewhere you become a section officer through Staff Selection Commission. Within 5 years, you become under secretary. Within another 5 years, you become deputy secretary. And suppose you enter at the age of 25, at the age of 40, 45, you are the director. And once you become a director, director is just like a head of the department of your department. So when you become a director, you'll be able to bring plan for the future of the country in your own ministry, in your own entity. You'll be able to decide the future of India and the Indians. Friends, for all this, they require a graduation. You have it in your hands. This is another area where we need to give a very closer look. If you just take Indian Army, there are jawans in Indian Army, non-commissioned officers in Indian Army, commissioned officers in Indian Army. The total strength of Indian Army is 12.5 lakh. Out of this 12.5 lakh, there are nearly 1 lakh people called officers. The balance are called jawans and sipais. These 1 lakh officers, they control the entire team of nearly, the entire team of nearly 11.5 lakh jawans and sipais. Unfortunately, we are not having these 1 lakh officers in Indian Army. There are 38,000 vacancies in Indian Army alone. There is a big dearth of officers. I'm not touching about the Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. There is a big, big gap. And to become an officer in Indian Army or Indian Navy or Indian Air Force, you are required to write a competitive examination called the NDA, if you are a plus two guy, National Defense Academy, or a Combined Defense Services Examination, CDSE. Now, directly you can get into through NCC direct entry, or you can appear for the staffs, SSB, Services Selection Board, and then you can directly get into Indian Army, Navy, and Air Force. Since you are all graduates, I appeal all of you to become officers in Indian Army. With the 10th standard qualification, with the 8th standard qualification, with plus two qualifications, there's a recruitment for jawans and sipais. But since you're already graduates, why don't you give the CDSE ones, Combined Defense Services Examination, Naval Defense Academy, NDA, or if you are younger than younger in age, you can write National Defense Academy. Women's Short Service Commission for 10 years have come in Indian Army. Permanent Commission called PC is available. For all that, you would need to take an examination. And you have to go for a physical service selection board for 5 days. And then they check your body completely for your medical fitness. And once you are sent for training in Indian Military Academy in Dehradun or in Officer Training Academy in Thambram, OTA, soon after training, see, you are now a graduate, you write an examination, you clear an examination, you go for the selection, you get yourself selected, you go for a medical examination, you get selected, you go for training, your training is over, you'll have 2 stars on your shoulders for lieutenant, 3 stars, captain, major, lieutenant colonel, colonel, brigadier, major general, Lieutenant General, General of Indian Army. You will control the entire country as the General of Indian Army. Friends, they require only a graduation, an examination for Army, for Navy, and for Air Force. So if you prepare accordingly, sincerely, meticulously, right from today, this moment onwards, within next 6 months, you'll be ready for the examination. Graduation is there. I have my community certificate. My age is well within the margin. I spend at least 10 hours a day sitting in my house, occupying my house as a coaching center myself. Need not spend a single pie extra for going to any coaching center. Materials are very much available online. The previous year question papers are available online. Enough study materials are available in the market. 3-4 friends can join together. You know, you can share some money and buy all materials. Evening 8 till morning 6, nobody's going to disturb you. The whole night is at your disposal. 6 months continuous rigorous preparation. You clear the examination. Interview, the Vishay Vibhar guy will definitely clear an interview. And the training and placement dinner is very much available for you guys to guide you for the interviews. And then medical fitness is your individual. Then you take your flight and leave to Dehradun for your training. And no sooner the training is over when you wear that olive green uniform, the white and white uniform, either Indian Army or Navy or Air Force, and you walk like a gentleman officer, the salary given is minimum 1 lakh per month. Everything is taken care of by the Government of India. Every year you get 2 months of holidays, paid holidays. Pride in your walk and speech. Where did we try? Indian Armed Forces. Vacancies are available. Everything is in our hand. Only thing is to give a try. In the Navy, we got executive branch, engineering branch, electrical branch, and education branch. That educational branch is requiring a BEd. So if you're very focused, a BSc physics or a BSc mathematics or a BSc chemistry student, even botany, zoology, even BBA, BCom, BA English, BA history, BA economics, BA Tamil, BA religious studies, with a Bachelor of Education, B.Ed. After your graduation, go join a B.Ed college, B.Sc. B.Ed, B.A. B.Ed. You can apply for this educational branch to become teachers. You'll be teaching the Jawans. You'll be teaching the Sipais. Nearly 11.5 lakh people are available across the country. The institutes, the colleges on the different sector are so beautiful. You'll be treated on par with an officer with all the ranking I told you, right from lieutenant, captain, major, lieutenant colonel, and all that. They have beautiful quarters for you, a vehicle to travel, somebody to help you in cooking, a cook is given to you, a lasker is given to you, a safai wala is given to you for your cleaning, and a driver is there for a car. You have a few in an attendant in office. 7 people called orderlies are there at your disposal. Can you imagine? An officer in Indian Army, Navy, Air Force. He walks and talks like a Maharaja or a Maharani. Try to get in touch. For further clarifications, please call us the Dean of Training and Placement. We'll be able to help you. Not only Indian Army, Navy, Air Force, we are interested in getting into the Special Action Group. Next to the President, you must have seen Z++ category. Black Hats, the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu is given Black Hat security. You must have seen when Sir went to Delhi. He was given the bulletproof car. And then 21 people, armed. You can become one such special action group, special ranger groups. When the earlier President of America, what's his name? Obama came to India. 1,800 special action group people landed in Delhi. They are the security officers for the President of America. President of India, Vice President of India, Speaker of Lok Sabha, all central ministers, all the chief ministers, all the governors, they rely on the special action group, special security group, national security guard, become a commandant there, become an officer there, and become the high class officer to control the best politicians of the country, so that, you know, we keep the pillars of the country standing tall with great happiness. Central Armed Police Forces, Border Security Force, Ministry of Home Affairs controls everything, Industrial Security Forces, CISF, CRPF, ITBP, they're called allied forces of the police department. Not required to just join the Tamil Nadu police alone, or IPS and then get posted as a police in law and order or in the traffic alone. You can be a warrior in the borders. You can take care of all the airports. CISF, BSF, CRPF, they control all the national and international airports. If we are safe flying, if all the airports are safe, if all the railway stations are safe, we need to be gratitude enough for the RPF and CRPF and CISF. These people, you know, toil night and day, 24/7, all 24 hours. You can become a commandant there, a deputy commandant there. You can become an officer. And for your command, people should be waiting. You can make India a bit stronger. For all this, you require a graduation. And you need to explore. Another 5 minutes, my session will get over. Waiting for the question and answer sessions. Aptitude, basic arithmetic, reasoning ability, general knowledge, English, and communication skills. I think Vishwavidyalaya College has given me a good communication skill. Whatever I was talking to you with the little interruption in between of the power failure, you are able to understand. You are able to get connected with me. And you are able to really understand that since I am talking in English. English is already there. You are exposed to the general knowledge, reading newspapers and listening to the national and international news. So last three, general knowledge, English, communication skill has already been given to you through a graduation in Vishwavidyalaya College. An extra mile that you have to walk is to learn something about aptitude and basic mathematics and reasoning ability, which requires some 6 months of 8 hours preparation daily, either individually or in a team. Within 6 months, you guys become ready to get into any of this. I have not touched railways. Railway conducts examination for non-technical popular categories. NTPC, non-technical popular categories for arts and science students. Technical categories for engineering graduates. Indian Railway has got around 12.5 lakh employees. They have 13 lakh employees. And every year, 1 lakh vacancies are available. They are also the tests. Aptitude, arithmetic, reasoning, general knowledge. Friends, before I conclude, I'd like to remind all of you that for all these postings, all these ministries, all these places, either UPSC or TNPSC or bank or defense or Staff Selection Commission or railways, they are asking you to sit for an examination which requires a basic degree. We have got it. They ask you to come for interview except Indian Railways. You have to go for a face-to-face interview and you have to be medically fit. And all these examinations, touched, can be also written in Tamil. Not necessary that you should write only in English or Hindi. Now almost all the examinations are come in vernacular Tamil. Language is also in our own mother tongue. If you are from Tamil medium, nothing wrong. You can prepare the examinations in Tamil and write. Even an IAS examinations can be written in Tamil. So friends, High time you started your preparation. Thank you very much for listening. God bless all your endeavors. I am ready for your questions.
Thank you, sir, for giving our students a well-detailed information about preparing for government jobs. And I hope our students will feel this webinar session very useful and they will come up with prime products. Once again, thank you so much, sir, for your time and effort which you have put up for this webinar for the benefit of our students. And my dear students, I have just posted a feedback form in the chat box. Kindly fill it up. Students who are filling the feedback form along, we'll be giving the e-certificates. And now the stage is open for the question and answer session. Feel free to ask. You can unmute yourself and you ask the question, or you can just drop down the chat box.
Now, there is a question in the chat box. Somebody has asked about writing UPSC in the ink pen. You're talking about, I think, a prelim examination is only YMR sheet. There you'll have to mark only with the ballpoint pen, and that they have already given clear instructions. But main examinations, they have not given any restrictions on ink pen or ballpoint. It has to be a blue ink or black ink. Cannot be a red ink. So you can definitely write in ink pen. Nothing wrong with that. But the thing is, it should be clear. Your handwriting should be very clear. In fact, if you are really aspiring to write UPSC examinations, please take 1 or 2 months of coaching in Bishop Paper itself. Calligraphy department is available, wherein they will tune your handwriting very beautifully. Our college has got the calligraphy, a very beautiful department there. And you can just learn. They will make your handwriting easier. Handwriting becomes. Thanks for the question. That's a good question.
Any questions, please,
friends. And this is not the final session. No. For further clarification, you're most welcome to contact our training and placement division. There's a big team. We have a dean, 3 associate deans, a training and placement officer, and 6 assistant placement officers. There are people who are here to help us. The office, there are 2 gentlemen in the office to help us. It's a big team. And we are ready to work, help. And then personally, if you cannot even ask any questions here, you are most welcome to send a mail to us. We'll also reply through mail. RRB examination. Thank you. I skipped it for want of time. There are 2 things, RRC and RRB. Railway Recruitment Cell, Railway Recruitment Board. Railway Recruitment Cell, it is for basic categories. Railway Recruitment Board is for a clerical category, both in offices and in the ticketing counters, commercial clerks, reservation clerks, station masters, guards, loco pilots who run the trains. And these are the categories in RRB. And in RRB examination, thanks, I don't know who has posted the question, that's a very good question. RRB examinations, once you clear the examination, there is no interview at all. There is no interview. You clear the examinations, you come into the rank list, your certificates are verified, you are asked to go for a medical examination in the railway hospital. And then once you are medically fit, you are sent to the training institute appropriately for training. If it is a clerical category, you go for 1 month training. If it is a station master, you go for 3 months training. If it is commercial apprentice, you go for 2 years of training. And if it's a loco pilot, you go for 6 months training, depending upon the category. And then you are posted in the place. So you need to write only the examination. To take 1 step extra, I was in railways for nearly 2.5 decades, 25 years. The examination, the question pattern is, you know, prelim examination, sorry, the RRB examination. They test your knowledge in arithmetic, reasoning, general knowledge, and some basic English. And so now they are not testing even English. Reasoning, arithmetic, and general knowledge. So when they test, around 100 questions will be there. The topper gets 100 out of 100. And we are not selecting people lesser than 99. So even if you score 98, you are not failing, but you are not qualified. So if you really aspire to take the railway examination, please prepare to score 100 out of 100. And people from other states, particularly from Bihar and Rajasthan, they are scoring 100 out of 100 because their business is to study for RRB right from the first year they get into the college. They are just waiting only for getting a degree. 3 years, they completely study the entire books available in the country. And they go for an RRB examination with 3 years of rigorous training, practice. And then they'll 2 hours we give them for writing examination for nearly 100 questions. They'll complete within 15 minutes. And they will give the result in the examination hall. And they say, sir, we are getting 100 out of 100. Your study should be right.
Next question is revenue recruitment board and railway recruitment board.
Yeah, that's okay. Somebody has asked about TNPSC group 2. There is a WhatsApp going around for all of you. It came this morning to me. Since somebody phoned that I am taking a class today for review, they have given it here. I'll just read for the people. TNPSC இல் எத்தனை குரூப் உள்ளது உங்களுக்கு தெரியுமா? குரூப் 7 8 பற்றி தெரியுமா? See, this is a nice WhatsApp which is now circulated all over the students group. அதுல போட்டிருக்காங்க குரூப் 1 அப்படின்னா என்ன, துணை கலெக்டர் அதான் டெப்டி கலெக்டர், துணை போலீஸ் சூப்பரண்ட், டெப்டி சூப்பரண்ட் ஆஃப் போலீஸ், மாவட்ட பதிவாளர். நான் உங்களுக்கு ஸ்லைட்ல காமிச்சிட்டேன், டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் ரெஜிஸ்டர். ஆனா கேள்வி வந்திருக்கிறது என்னன்னா, you are asking about group 2. அதல இதுலயே போட்டிருக்காங்க group 2 னா என்ன, துணை வணிக வரி அதிகாரி, நகராட்சி ஆணையர், கார்ப்பரேஷன் கமிஷனர், நகராட்சி ஆணையர், இளைய வேலை வாய்ப்பு அதிகாரி, ஜூனியர் பிளேஸ் சாரி எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட் ஆபீசர், இளைய தொழிலாளர் உதவி ஆய்வாளர், லேபர் என்போர்ஸ்மெண்ட் ஆபீசர், உதவி பிரிவு அதிகாரி சட்டம் மற்றும் நிதி தவிர, தமிழ்நாடு பொது சேவை பப்ளிக்ல தமிழ்நாடு பொது சேவையில் உதவி பிரிவு அதிகாரி, நன்னடத்தை அலுவலர், தொழில்துறை கூட்டுறவு அதிகாரி, பெண்கள் நல அலுவலர், கோஆபரேட்டிவ் சொசைட்டி சப் ரிஜிஸ்ட்ரார். நிறைய போது I will forward this to you, all your mobile numbers. Yeah, he has posted. Super. It has been posted for you guys. Thank you, Moses. Yeah.
Next question is...
Our placement officers are very shrewd. It has already come. You think, apadiya, then you can capture it. Please capture. See, we live in a very beautiful era of technology. Naange padikarathukulla avan post panta. One of the students has posted. Thank you, Liam. God bless you. That's great work.
The next question is, give some info about AAO and Junior Statistical Officer.
Assistant Administrative Officer is AAO. This is Statistical Officers, normally they were selecting from people who did the BSc Statistics and MSc Statistics. Now, since you study Statistics in BSc Mathematics itself, or Mathematics, MSc Mathematics in OVR Operations Research, you are now allowed to write the statistical inspector's examination. I'll talk about AAO a little later. Statistical inspector examinations, you become statistical officers. Every district has got a statistics office where a statistical officer is available. And once you become a director, you are of a district collector rank. You need to write an exam. Basically, you will need to have BSc Mathematics. Statistics as well, right? BSc Statistics alone, St. Joseph's College and Lila College, as I think that they got BSc statistics and MSc statistics. Maybe other colleges might also have, to my knowledge. So if you are, first of all, if you have that graduation, I tell you, it's very easier. You go to Google and then type your degree. BA Tamil Literature. You are doing BA Tamil, for example. Just type BA Tamil Literature in Google. You just type, after that you say plus sign, and write jobs available in Tamil Nadu, plus jobs available in India, plus job available abroad. சும்மா பிஏ தமிழ்னு சொல்லியிருக்கேன். நீங்க உங்க டிகிரியை போட்டுங்க. ஒரு டிகிரியை போட்டுட்டு பிபிஏ பிஎஸ்சி பாட்டனி பிளஸ் ஜாப்ஸ் அவைலபிள் இன் தமிழ்நாடு பிளஸ் ஜாப்ஸ் அவைலபிள் இன் இந்தியா பிளஸ் ஜாப் அவைலபிள் அப்ராட் வெளிநாடு. நிறைய பேஜஸ் ஓப்பன் ஆகும். அதுல சும்மா பிஏ தமிழுக்குன்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா போட்டிருப்பா சிங்கப்பூர்ல வேலை இருக்கு, மலேசியால வேலை இருக்கு. இந்த உலக தமிழ்நாடு நடந்ததுக்கு அப்புறமா உலகம் எங்கும் எல்லா யூனிவர்சிட்டிலுமே there is a chair for Tamil. செம்மொழி அந்தஸ்து வந்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் ஹார்வர்ட்ல கூட சேர் வந்துருச்சு. அங்க you can go as a professor or you can go there as a person linking India with that particular university. இதெல்லாம் சர்ச் பண்ணி பார்த்து அதை அப்படியே ஒரு பெரிய டைரி எடுத்து கட்ட 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 எழுதுன்னு ஒரு டைரி ஃபுல்லா 10 days hard work. நான் படிச்ச படிப்பு தமிழகத்துல எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் வேலை இருக்கு, இந்தியாவில் எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் வேலை இருக்கு, உலகத்துல எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் வேலை இருக்கு. உங்க அப்பா செய்ய மாட்டாங்க, உங்க அம்மா செய்யறது ஒர்க் நீங்க தான் செய்யணும். I think this lockdown will help you guys to do all that. You got enough time at home. 7 days, switch off your mobile phone, don't talk to anybody, close your room, do this activity, and then you will understand. You know, appa thumba irukku da. Then decide what you want to become.
Explain about insurance sector.
Sorry, somebody asked about AAM. Adoda the question is solren. Somebody has asked about insurance sectors. Yeah, thank you. That's a good question. Life Insurance Corporation, General Insurance Corporation, or any insurance of the Government of India, adhe potrukom and LIC kila or bracket la potrupan, a Government of India undertaking, statutory body of the Government of India, the Coal India Limited potrupan kila potrupan, idhu or arasu saranda nirvanam appadi potrunda the government odaya allied factor, it's called allied industry, or it is also called public sector. மீது எல்லாம் பஜாஜ் அலையன்ஸ் மற்ற அதர் இன்சூரன்ஸ் ஆர் பிரைவேட் இன்சூரன்ஸ். சின்ஸ் யூ ஆர் ஆல் கிராஜுவேட்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் பிஷப் காலேஜ், பிளீஸ் ட்ரை டு கெட் இன் டு கவர்மெண்ட் இன்சூரன்ஸ் பிகாஸ் அங்கே ப்ரொமோஷன்ஸ் ஆர் வெரி ஃபாஸ்ட். இனிஷியலி சம்டைம்ஸ் யூ பிகம் பீப்புள் சே நீங்கள் ஏஜென்டா வாங்க, ஏஜென்டா போனால் 10th ப்ளஸ் 2 தான் போதும். சின்ஸ் யூ ஆர் ஆல் கிராஜுவேட்ஸ் become DO, development officers. Development officer ku adutha mail rank da AAO, assistant administrative officer. Then you become an AO. Idukala nam actual science padikira students try pannalam, BSc mathematics, BSc physics chemistry with allied paper as mathematics. Ena the examination ku nariya mathematical calculations irukku. Even arts stream people can also try, provided you can work the examination very well. So DO, development officer vacancies are, if a fellow who has done BBA or BCom, who knows the marketing value, who knows how to do marketing, if he becomes a DO, he can get more policies. Not only the LIC or GIC is benefited, you're also benefited through commissions. Assistant Administrative Officer, AAO, is the desk job, office work. Administrative Officer is an officer, desk job. But the Development Officer has to go, he has to recruit more of agents, train the agents, and then take them for to the market to get more policies. So my honest advice will be to get into government sectors, writing an examination. Maybe other insurance sectors may directly take you through recruitments. And maybe with 1 or 2 years, they may ask you to leave also. But here, the job is secure in the government insurance sectors. Okay, thank you.
So the next question is, please explain CBI associate.
CBI, Central Bureau of Investigation. This posting is very, you know, majority of the youngsters, they are really interested in getting into CBI. Maybe, you know, you have a, you are a plain cloth man, you need not wear any uniform. And area cinema la paathirukku or aasa undu CBI la handover panitaanga CBI nalla. Actually, majority of the policemen who are already recruited in the police department, they are recruited as CBI CIDs, crime branch CIDs. And CBI, if you have to really want to become a CBI officer, you have to write Staff Selection Commission exam, SSC. And this examination is just like, you know, Inspector of Income Tax, Inspector of Customs, Inspector of Central Excise, Inspector of Narcotics, Inspector of Enforcement. One such examination is Inspector of CBI. But once you are selected, your identity is not revealed. Even your own parents, your own friends, your own relatives, your own sister and brother will not know that you are working for CBI. If you are ready for that, take up the examination and you'll be directly under the control of Government of India, Ministry of Home Affairs.
Next question is, which mode of study do you prefer, sir? Self-study or joining coaching center for TNPSC?
Majority of the coaching centers, they can only guide you. And these coaching centers, you know, they came, you know, it is a mushroom growth of coaching centers came. And for a very simple reason is that none of us are taking the help from the computers or through internet. The sessions that I've taken today, since I was in the government for nearly 25 years, I fairly know many departments. Not every department, but fairly more departments. But that was not enough for my preparation. I Googled many things. I sat in the computer for nearly 15, 20 days to collect various information, and my diary is full of information. This somebody does a homework. Suppose I start a coaching center today, I'll be the best coaching center in it. So like that, somebody sits and prepares, starts a company, starts a coaching center, and takes the money from your pockets to just guide you as what the training and placement commission is doing. What the dinner is doing, somebody is doing in some place. I don't believe in that at all. When I can do it, you can do it 200 times better than me. Close the room, open your laptop, connect daily for 4 or 5 hours, write it, jot it down in the diary. Or if you have like-minded friends, 3-4 can sit together, do this homework, do a kind of a counseling, maybe go to 1 or 2 experts to find out whether the path that you have chosen is right. One such expertise is given from our deanery. You can contact us.
So the next question is, can you explain government jobs for BSc and MSc nutrition and dietetics?
Nutrition dietetics are not that, that's a good question. Maybe I'm not that clear about it. But I come to know that all these beverages that we drink, all the food that we take in the hotels, they need to be standardized through an ISI or FSSI mark, which requires somebody to test as quality inspectors, for which this graduation might be of much use. I'm not conversant with that. I'm so sorry. But the person who has asked the question is asked to take my mobile number from the deanery and kindly contact me. I'll be with the answer within 1 or 2 days. But before that, we had an opportunity to visit the National Institute in Tanjavur, Food Processing Institute in Tanjavur, where it's a national institute, where the faculty members have done the BSc MSc practice. They have their own, bakery. They make all food items there. They have their own kitchen, and they have their own quality control. So people who are learning BSc that food science, you are welcome to visit that institute in Hyderabad. You already visited. Kindly, Dr. Isaiah, you are the head of the department, to take you to that institute in Tanjavur. That's a national institute, which can throw more light on these areas. Possibly in 2 days, I'll come with the results, and we'll be able to keep in touch with you. Thank you for that question.
So the next question is, do we need to focus on the particular streams, because most of them say that you should study for a particular fields, either banking or TNPSC or SSC?
That's what that last slide I showed you said, that 90% of the examinations, they are testing on the basic reasoning ability, the aptitude, arithmetic. I didn't go much deep into that, but they are testing only through those questions. For example, if you take basic arithmetic, need not study BSc mathematics to answer the basic arithmetic questions or logical reasoning. This basic arithmetic notes or booklet will contain 22 chapters. Simple interest, compound interest, profit and loss, percentage, allegation, mixture, upstream, downstream, like that, some 18-22 chapters are there. If you are thorough with all the 22 chapters, taking each chapter, and from each chapter making some 100 question, different types of patterns of question answers, studying for 6 months continuously, writing and working out the sums, 40 questions will appear in the examination. You can score 40 out of 40. Simultaneously, 2 hours daily for reasoning, logical reasoning, analogy, and then there are the 4 patterns in logical reasoning. If you do all the 4 patterns and learn, 40 questions are asked, 40 out of 40. 20 questions are asked normally from general knowledge. If you are regularly reading a newspaper every day for next 365 days, 1 year, regularly sitting for CNN or BBC News every day between 9 and 11 in the night, listening and taking notes from the news that you learn from the television, 20 out of 20. General English, 20 questions, 20 out of 20. 40 plus 40 plus 20 plus 20, 80 plus 20, 120. 120 questions, 120 minutes, 120 marks. Eggs of bees, 120 you get, you are the topper. Need not wait for the computer to value your answer script. This is a mantra, or this is a sutra.
So the last question, students, I have just posted my mail ID. If you have any questions or doubts or want any help, kindly do or mail me. To that mail ID, we'll revert you back. The last question is, what do you think about CAT exam, sir? How is it useful for other government exams?
That's a very good question. I know who was asked. I mean, maybe I'd like to know the name of the person who asked this.
Bharati Prasad.
Bharati Prasad. That's great. Bharati, you really asked a very nice question. CAT means a common admission test. Thank you. That's a good question. One of the toughest examinations. CAT, MAT, SAT. The SAT matter, but CAT is very tough. I will not call anything tough, because a person who regularly works on it, it becomes very easy. When I ask you a question, what is 2 plus 2? You laugh at me, sir, it's a lot of KLBR, sir. But that's a math question. 2 plus 2 cannot be 5 or 6, it's only 4. பட் ஆப்ஷன்ல கொடுத்துருக்காங்க 2+2 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 2. ஆப்ஷன் ஏ 5, ஆப்ஷன் பி 7, ஆப்ஷன் சி லைக் தட் தே கிவ் யூ 4 ஆப்ஷன்ஸ். ஒன்லி திங்க் யூ கட்டா பிக் தி ரைட் ஆப்ஷன். பட் வென் யூ ரீட் தட் க்வெஸ்சன் 2+2 இஸ் வாட், நமக்கு சிரிப்பா வரும். சப்போஸ் ஆல் த க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் இன் தி கேட் எக்ஸாமினேஷன்ஸ் உங்களுக்கு சிரிப்பு உண்டாக்குச்சுன்னா, யூ ஹவ் மாஸ்டர்ட் தட் எக்ஸாமினேஷன். அதான் அர்த்தம். எந்த கேள்வி கேட்டாலும் தெரியும், ஐ ஹவ் வர்க் 2 இயர்ஸ் ஆஃப் வர்க், ஐ ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட் ஆல் தி பேட்டர்ன்ஸ், ஐ ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட் ஆல் தி நோட்ஸ் அவைலபிள் ஆன் எர்த் ஃபார் யுவர் யூஜி டிகிரி ஆர் பிஜி டிகிரி. ஃபைனல் எக்ஸாம் நாங்கள் என்ன டெஸ்ட் பண்றோம், வி ஆஸ்க் யூ 21 மார்க் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ், மல்டிபிள் சாய்ஸ். ஆன்லைன் டெஸ்ட்ல அப்படி தான் நடந்தது. ஃபைனல் செமஸ்டர் 21 மார்க் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ். இந்த 21 மார்க்குக்கும் ஏபிசிடி போட்டிருக்கிறோம், எதுக்குமே உங்களுக்கு ஆன்சர் தெரியல. 20க்கும் ஏ போட்டா தான் இருக்கும். சப்போஸ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் கிவன் ஒன்லி டிக் ஃபார் ஆல் தி ஏ, ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நம்பர் 1 ஏ, பி ரெண்டாவது க்வெஸ்சன் ஏ, மூணாவது ஏ, அட்லீஸ்ட் 7 வில் பி ரைட் மேம். ஆனா நீங்க என்ன பண்றீங்கன்னா, வி ஹவ் ஆல்ரெடி கிவன் யூ 250 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ், 1 மார்க் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ். க்வெஸ்சன் பேங்க் இஸ் கிவன் டு யூ 550 or 40 questions from each unit we have given. நீங்க என்ன பண்றீங்க, அந்த 250 படிச்சிட்டு ஆர் 200 இஸ் வித் யூ, வி ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் ஒன்லி 20. ஸோ யூ ஸ்கோர் 20 out of 20. See, when we value the papers, objective everybody gets 20 out of 20. Because you already got the question bank. QB is there. So a fellow preparing for CAT exam, you know what he does? He prepares the QB according to the syllabus. 10,000 question answers are there with him. Out of this 10,000, they ask us 100 questions in CAT. But this 10,000 question he has prepared for next 3 years, past 3 years. So when he goes to the exam hall, 100 questions are there, but time is not enough. So the topper is able to write only 40 questions or 35 questions. So here they are not calculating percentage, Bharati. They are testing percentile, percentage, A-G-E. Percentile, T-I-L-E, percentile. So out of 10,000, 20,000 people appearing for exams, the topper has touched only 40, others have touched only lesser than that. 40 will be considered as 100. The 40-க்கு அவன் 40 வாங்கிட்டா, he is called 100 percentile. 39 will be called 99.8 percentile, like that. So based on the topper's score, other score will be decided. Whereas in other examinations, everybody scores 100, so 100 is taken as the topper. So CAT examination, I will not say it is tough preparation. It's a regular preparation. So if somebody prepares for CAT, they will do quick mathematics. Their brain is tuned for logical reasoning. So a person preparing for CAT can easily clear any exams, but they will not write exams. A person preparing for CAT can clear any exam, but they will not write these SSC or UPSC, because there is something better than lucrative than this called IIM, Indian Institute of Management. 19 places in the country. We have got one in Trichy itself. But the ABCD is the best. A for Ahmedabad, B for Bombay, C for Calcutta, D for Delhi. We also have it in Calicut. We also have it in Bangalore. We also have it in Tiruchirappalli. We also have it in other locations. But these four institutes are the best according to people who have gone to IIM, they say. So people preparing for CAT, so maybe I would rather put it this way. People who prepare for CAT, the amount of energy they put, if people, you know, put it for a bank or put it for a UPSC, all the postings in the government sector the next years, coming years, is going to be the posting for a herbarium. Just imagine a scene like this. All the ministries, all the industries, all the government sectors, Ramana Parthala Madhuri, all the postings are taken by Vishwavidya students. That day we will stop taking classes like this. You will take classes for your juniors. That change should happen with your all your hard work and homework. Thank you very much for getting connected with us.
Thank you so much, sir, for patiently answering our students' questions. Gratitude is not only the greatest of virtues, but the parent of all others. Now I request our associate dean, to pay Shiva Princess Ma'am, to give the oath of thanks. Over to you, ma'am.
We are unmuting a mic, ma'am.
Am I audible, Moses? Moses, am I audible? Am I audible, Moses?
Yes, ma'am. You are audible, ma'am. We can hear you.
Okay. Training and placement is one of the very busy deaneries in the college, organizing trainings and finding placement for the students. As part of this exercise, it has organized today's webinar on preparing for government jobs. At this outset, I would like to thank Dr. Victor Lazarus, the Associate Dean for Training and Placement, for elaborating us on various job opportunities in the government sectors and guiding us how to prepare for them. Thank you so much, sir. I think this is the best webinar I have listened to in the last 1.5 years online. And the very presence of 125 students throughout the session and so many questions which are very relevant to the what you spoke will vouch for what I tell. Thank you so much for the information and for guiding the students, sir. I would like to thank Dr. Dhanapal, Dean for Training and Placement, for being the driving force behind all the endeavors of the deanery. I would also like to thank Dr. Isaiah, the Associate Dean for Training and Placement, for his guidance and support. I place on record my hearty appreciation and thanks to Dr. Anita, the Placement Officer of the Training and Placement Division, for not only arranging this webinar, but for her tireless effort in placing the students of our college in various institutions. I thank Mr. Moses, Mrs. Nancy, and the rest of the Assistant Placement Officers of the Deanery for helping us in organizing this seminar and all the other activities of the deanery. I would also like to thank all the students who attended this webinar. Hope this webinar was very informative. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Once again, I thank each and everyone who have attended this webinar through Zoom and YouTube. Wishing you all success and blessings. God bless, stay safe, and take care. This is Moses signing off from Team Training and Placement Division. Wishing you